I'm here at one of my favorite spots in the city to find out if this Skydio drone right here is gonna be able to track my Supra as I drive through this industrial area. This area is pretty much deserted for the most part. There's semis parked here, there's buildings all over, there's telephone poles and power lines and all sorts of obstructions. So I'm gonna set it to track my car from like maybe a 45 degree angle from the rear. Since it's about 15 or 20 feet out, it's gonna run into the buildings and all sorts of obstructions. I wanna push this thing to the limit, see what it does. All right, here we go. I'm going to show an overlay of my phone just to give you an idea of what I was telling the drone to do and what it did. And I'm gonna edit through this whole thing to make it shorter so it's not 30 minutes long. I thought this drone was pretty amazing and can do a lot of shots that other drones just can't do. You're about to see what I'm talking about. So if you watch my phone screen overlay, you can see what inputs I'm giving the drone. I'm telling it to follow me from the right, then the front, and I'm switching it back and forth as the drone is tracking my car. My whole idea here is to confuse the drone and see what it does.
I'll see you guys later. How are you too? Look at that thing, that's crazy. Let me switch sides, go to the front. Check that out. Now I'm going to the front left. And now I'm gonna go to the rear left. And now I'm gonna make a left turn. Track behind me. About 30 miles an hour, 35 miles an hour. I'm gonna try to put it in the front of me, and there it goes. So it went right to the front, even though I'm doing 35 right now. Passed me up, but let me go and get the back view again. Man, that's crazy, though. That thing just goes to the building all on its own. That's insane. Do a little burnout here one more time. That is crazy. Okay, so I'm just gonna make a left turn here now. And I'm going to bring it like front left because there's like trucks and cables and everything everywhere. Man, that thing goes right away. Right, I'm just gonna make a left here, go down to the end, and then I'm gonna make a U-turn. I'm gonna turn around here. Thank you. left. Right, left. Look at that thing. That's crazy. It's right next to the building. To end this video, I'm going to show you one of my favorite shots that the drone did from this day that I was out here shooting. Okay, so my question has been answered. Yes, the Skydio can track my Supra through this area here. That was pretty insane. I haven't had a smile on my face this big in a long time. I did not think that this thing was gonna be able to track my car that well through all of those obstacles. I was switching it from front to back, trying to confuse it, and this thing was just flying so aggressive. I mean, it feels a little bit weird just to like completely hand over all the decisions to the artificial intelligence of the drone. That being said, I'm not gonna go into any details about this drone simply because I might do that in the full episode on warped perception. And this is not sponsored by Skydio. I thought the technology was interesting. I've been following their development for, I don't know, a few years now since they started. I thought it was a great concept, great idea, and definitely futuristic, that's for sure. I mean, the fact that this thing can just create its own 3D environment that it flies through at that speed, I mean, the amount of data processing that's going on in this drone is, it's gotta be crazy. But I did wanna mention that when I film these things, I do have insurance, and I am very courteous. For instance, here, I went to all the truck drivers that I can see, and I told them what I was doing, and they were totally cool with it. If anyone was against it, I just wouldn't film it here. A lot of people write in the comments like, oh, you're being reckless, you're doing this in this area. I get permits, permission, and I have insurance for all this stuff. I don't just come out and shoot it. So thanks for watching. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And again, this was the initial testing for the warp perception episode. I just figured I would share it with everybody. I thought it was a nice, fun video. So tell me what you think. See you soon.